because mood is pretty.
Hello, welcome to a brand new Let's Play, The Sea Will Claim Everything by Jonas Kyratzes. I am Amethyst Notari, the RPG chick. This is another one of a series of his games set in the Lands of Dream. And I enjoyed the other games. The Book of Living Magic, The Fabulous Screech, which I just played recently, and which drew me into this game. I was going to play some other things, as, well, anyone who's like watching this currently might have saw on my about page for YouTube, but I'm gonna play this before playing that because I want to. So let's take a look at the credits. Really, if this was a game, the credits might read like this. So Jonas is the writer and programmer, as far as I'm aware, and Verena is his wife, who does all the art that you're going to see inside. So, of course, yeah, writing graphics, that's right in there. Music is by Chris Christodoulou for Christina. At this recording, he has a whole bunch of music. So just search for his name on YouTube, or search for The Sea Will Claim Everything. As far as I can see so far, really excellent music, same as all the Lands of Dream series. Anyway, let's initiate a new connection. Attention! You are entering the Lands of Dream. Time runs at a different pace here, and should you attempt to interact with things at the same speeds as you do elsewhere, the experience may be highly unpleasant. Relax, slow down, take your time. Look at that. Okay, I'm gonna fix this because we're not entirely centered on the window here. You know what? I don't think we can be centered on the window here because this frame is not... It's slanted slightly. I don't know if you can tell, but well, I can tell because when you start Cam Studio to go in a fixed region, well, it's basically you can make a square or a rectangle, and this is not straight like a rectangle. Anyway, hopefully the little black on some of the sides won't bother you too much. Speaking of taking your time, I'm going to be reading all the text in this game that does, you know, at least, you know, once. Some repeat things I, you know, will probably, you know, not say, but it's going to be a lot of reading. So if you guys don't like a lot of reading or don't like somebody reading everything to you, just buy the game. It's $10. So I don't think there's any other Let's Plays out here of this game or walkthroughs. There's a Let's Almost Play, which is like 20-something minutes long, and he stops there. So, I think... Or maybe I'm thinking of The Fabulous Screech. No, that would be the entire game. There's a Let's Almost Play by somebody. I'm gonna stop rambling now. I often think about that old metaphor, the one that says we are all islands on a wide sea, especially these days. Now that things are more difficult than before, and the world appears to be harsher than we once imagined it to be. We are all like islands, the philosopher said. Perhaps it's true. Yet I cannot help but remember an older saying, scratched on a cave wall somewhere by a long-forgotten prophet. In the end, the sea will claim everything. The ancient words crash into my mind like waves, waking me from sleep, filling me with feelings I cannot fully understand. We are like islands. Does it mean we are connected? Do we share a common origin, or just the common fate of sinking? I'm sorry. I've drifted off into my thoughts again. You have come, and I should welcome you properly. Thank you for hearing my call, for using this window. I am in great need of assistance. Underhome was invaded by disgusting, violent goons, claiming it was being foreclosed. I kicked them out, but the house has panicked and nothing is working as it should. And I fear there is more evil at work here in the Fortunate Isles. Lord Urizen is putting pressure on our leaders, and his ships are tainting the seas with their filth. I wish I knew the details, but I'm stuck here, trying to keep everything in balance. You know, it would probably be a lot simpler to explain everything via the proper dialogue interface. Assuming it works, of course. I had to grow it all rather quickly. He grew it? Wait, the graphics are still off, aren't they? Silly me. Could you turn them on? It's that lever on your left. Okay. Well, that's not a lever then. Ah. That was me saying ah. And now I look and say ah. Much better. So let's give this a go. Click on the arrow, then on me, and hope nothing blows up. Okay, we've got all kinds of stuff filling in here. What does this do? Underhome, control room, and underhome. Okay, is this like a, you know, verbose and short? Okay, let's sound off. Volumes. I already have it set down to 10 in Windows. The music is loud. Let's look at this stuff. Okay, we've got save, load, weird sound, exit, and close. Connected to tablet. It's a tablet. That's the weird sound. Okay. It's a map. You haven't even made it off the third floor yet, let alone to the outside. Scroll open. Scroll of quests. Okay, cool. Inventory open. Cumbersome GUI enabled. Scroll of recipes. Automatically notes down all important recipes. Scroll opened. Okay, there's nothing there, of course. Smell it? It smells of digital papyrus. You're supposed to use these recipes to make things you can eat or drink, not eat or drink the recipes themselves. The mouse says that modern recipes are all well and good, but real cooking requires more than written instructions. Okay. Oh. I didn't mean to do that, yeah. What we got here? A portrait of Rupert, Mysterious Druid. I guess that's him. It's a painting of Herbert, Mysterious Druid. Oh, it's a family of druids. Hi. Oh, that's actually something you can talk to? Biotalkatron enabled. Wall of text active. Dialogue options functional. Smell of the day? That's Serna. I think there's nothing wrong with the air filtration system. I think there's something wrong with the air filtration system. It's not dangerous at the moment, but it needs to be fixed. I'd guess that all that needs to be done is for the correct setting to be engaged once. Underhome generally knows what it's supposed to do, it's just a little confused at the moment. Control room. This room is the heart of Underdome. Well, it's not really true. Did I say Underdome? Underhome. Actually has a real heart. It's about as big as a boulder. So, this room really isn't like a heart at all. I don't know why I said that. Just pretend I didn't. Imagine I said that this is the room from which the can control many of the house's functions. Okay, we have some typos here. Including its magical sensory organs. That's why he can't leave until the current crisis is over. From which he can control. Eddie? I'm talking to Eddie. So I'm talking to Eddie about Eddie. I've always had an irresistible desire to wear clothing. Some say it's inappropriate for a holographic AI to wear clothing. But why? I say do as you please, so long as it doesn't hurt anyone. And if someone disagrees, murder them. That was a joke. No, it wasn't. I'm a killer AI. No, I'm not. You would say that. Freaky, huh? True story. Foreclosure. The whole situation makes about as much sense as wheels on a giraffe, which is not a lot unless I've missed a real revolution in transportation. Fortunate Isles. There's three main islands, the Isle of the Sun, the Isle of the Stars, and the Isle of the Moon. Each has its own government and its own traditions, but relations have always been good. There used to be a lot of travel before the economy went bust. Now, not so much. I think that's a shame. Roots? Waikato mentioned something about the roots having absorbed the wrong materials from the ground. There are settings for that, which you can only access in the root cellar. Part of the problem is that no one has touched these settings for years, not since before the was born. Okay, so the is... maybe that's not a typo then. There's a lot we don't know about Underhome, sadly. So, the is the name of something. Somebody. Let's ask about the. I think he's made his family proud. It's not easy, being the son of such great thinkers and inventors, but he's taken care of Underhome with a great deal of dedication and love. Finally, Underhome. Everything's a bit of a mess at the moment, with the house being in shock, the being completely overworked, and me not having any hands. Does the word chaos ring a bell? Alright, so let's go to the scroll. Restore the air filtration system to its proper settings, and go to the cellar and fix the root settings. Okay. More portraits. I had no idea I would be talking to this thing. A chameleon mushroom, cleverly disguised as a portrait. A small portrait of Mutatio, the mysterious druid family dog. A tiny pink mushroom called Fred. A portrait of Theodore, mysterious druid, the black sheep of the family. This screen can only be operated by the and Niam. Underhome root system main. Okay. The machine's magnoliophytic impulse capacitor is humming pleasantly. It's obviously the machine's angiospermatological metagenic flux converter. The machine's petalonian plasma conduit. Sad thing. Anthic energy flows gently and silently. It's not very fast, but doesn't harm the environment. And it smells nice. This is the anthic discharge vent. It gives the room a very pleasant smell. Don't touch that, it'll turn you purple. Shh, Bob the Spider is performing his new opera under this rock. This lever controls the quantum micro gametophyte containment core. Better not mess with this lever, it controls the perianthic discriminator. This lever is purely decorative. This bottle contains 27 polypeptides, a bottle of liquid mustache ions, an amino acid lubricant primarily used in the creation of slippery proteins. Yeah, I'm going to be looking at everything here. This ancient stone spent thousands of years deep in the bowels of the earth in dark places where no human will ever go. It's useful for leaning against. The stone is older than any living creature, but it's still just a stone. Alright, books. Honorapolis University Guide to Magical Biotechnology, 22nd edition. The Movement of Power Implants by Charles Darwin. The Effects of Cross and Self-Fertilization in the Vegetable Kingdom, A Traveler's Guide by Charles Darwin. Political Structures in the Quantum State by Wimner, Hiron Mountain. Visual Encyclopedia of Exploding Mushrooms by the Onoropolis University Exploding Mushrooms Department. New Symmetries, Advanced Quantum Chromodynamics, and QCD Matter by Fred Bobble. New Symmetries, just read that one. Physics and Magic, Aspects of Force by Herb Al Tiedrinker, Joseph Brom et al. A Monograph on the Growing of Artificial Biocomputers by Garfandia Lalatron. On the Development Patterns of the Analytical Plant by Charles Babbage. Scientific Lectures on Familiar Subjects by John Herschel. Programming the Bioanalytical Engine by Professor Ada Lovelace. The Green Screen of Death and Other Common Problems in Technodruidism by Brickhen Oaknoer. Jerome Duga's Nearly Complete Guide to Fictional Technology. Snail is very male. a nail bought in the sale. On the Properties of Cellular Mitosis by Mr. Nose. The Principles of Biochoreology by Gene Kelly. Techno-Druidism in the Age of Superstition by Dr. Robert Tentacle. The Biotic Book of Biological Logic by Tantrimus Gargantuan. The Macro-Evolutionary History of Cookies by Dr. Insano. A small purple box of chocolates. The contents no longer resemble chocolate, but are beginning to approach full sentience. Structure of Evolutionary Theory by Stephen Jay Gould. Experiments in Mendel Hybridization by Robert Plant. Om Nom Pax, Essays in Light Cooking by Alistair Turley. The Taste in the Tongue by Alistair Turley. The Holy Book of Majorima by Alistair Turley. Eyeball Plants, A Botanical History by Esther Lederberg. Mathematical Formulation of the Quantum Theory of Electromagnetic Interaction by Richard P. Feynman. Surfing the Universal Wave Function by Hugh Everett. I can't look. Oh, that's just a divider. Mad Experiments with Human Flesh and Other Breakfast Materials by Andrew McCoy. Blubbering Glarb Bubbles in Biometric Quantum Quantrenium Foam Baths by Rotating Jack McSaltwater. Walking the Plank, A Piratical Approach to Physics by Edwin the Massively Bearded. This nail is not afraid of hail. This nail knows how to sail. A nail that's waiting to exhale. A candle made of communist wax. Candle made of magically solidified water. It's not very good. Okay, it's entirely possible that we've looked at everything in here. So, let's talk to the man himself. The Mysterious Druid. Hello there. Biochocotron enabled. Wall of text active. Dialogue options functional. Smell of the day. Lavender. It's not a new day. It's asking about the... Oh, that's his first name is The? The Mysterious Druid? Ha! I am the Mysterious Druid, scion of the Mysterious Druid family, devoted to the arts of techno-druidism, that is to say, to the making and shaping of living technology. I am fully aware of the ironic nature of my name and have come to see it as something to be oddly proud of. Please just call me The. Excuse me, let's ask him about Underhome. Underhome, these caverns and... rooms that you see around you have been the home of the Mysterious Druid family for generations. It was begun by Matilda, Mysterious Druid, my great-great-great-grandmother. But you must understand that this is no ordinary house. Underhome is a living being, a huge and complex creature quite unlike anything you know. It does not think and feel like you or I do, but it does think and feel, and what has happened to it is a violation. It is hurt and afraid and trying to protect itself and its inhabitants. Yes, about Eddie. Eddie is a holographic artificial intelligence that helps me take care of Underhome. Well, that is his function, but it's not all he is. He's not just a machine. He's also a transvestite with an excellent dress sense, a mean druidism, the reaping player, and my friend. He'll help you find your way around Underhome. Interesting character, to be sure. The Fortunate Isles are the place that this window that you see on your screen is connected to. We're on the Isle of the Moon, the northernmost of the isles. Two other major islands are the Isle of the Sun and the Isle of the Stars, though there are also many tiny unexplored islands around. It's a beautiful part of the Lands of Dream. And one I care deeply about. Window. Yes, the window allows you to directly interact with our world using nothing but that. Mouse, was it? I can never remember what kind of biotech the people of your world use. Thankfully, time runs differently in our two universes, so if you close the window and return later, no time will have passed on your side. The window also allows you to pick up objects and talk to people using special interfaces. Oh, and I'm sorry about the movement arrows. They're a bit rubbish, really, but I just didn't have the time to grow better ones. And help. I didn't even know where to begin. A group of goons entered Underhome a few days ago, claiming the house was being foreclosed, that I had to move out, and that they could take all my belongings. They broke several things, ruined an ancient carpet that belonged to my grandmother, and put the house into a state of panic. To make matters worse, the ecological and biomagical balance of the entire region seems to be in a flux. I'm trying to do what I can with the limited systems at my disposal, but it's not enough. And on top of that, I haven't heard back from Niam, my girlfriend, who went to investigate the imbalance several weeks ago. This is scroll updated, new conversation options enabled. Okay, so we can ask him about Niam, the foreclosure, and the healing underhome. I keep wanting to call it Underdome. Niam left several days before the foreclosure goons arrived. She was going to travel around, take some readings to help us understand the imbalances that we think were being caused by Lord Urizen's ships. She hasn't been gone long enough for me to be seriously worried, but if you could keep an eye out for her, I'd appreciate it. These are strange times, and we are not always safe when we should be. Foreclosure. Yes, apparently my house is facing foreclosure. But the thing is, as I tried to explain to these goons, I've never taken up a credit with a bank. It's absurd. Underhome has belonged to my family for generations. We built it ourselves. How dare these greedy monsters claim they can just take it away from us? Maybe Mayor Penglaw can help us figure out what is going on. Healing Underhome. Underhome is a living being, and the damage it has taken from the goons is both physical and psychological. Both types of damage may not be readily apparent, and may in some ways be interconnected. Ask the other inhabitants for help and advice, especially Wei Kato, the Tanawa fish on the second floor. He's lived here even longer than I have. My great-grandfather and he were close friends, having met in a faraway country where they speak in a very peculiar way. Wei Kato can swim through Underhome's arteries and find problems that are otherwise hard to detect. Okay, so now I find Niam also and heal Underhome. And investigate Underhome's pending foreclosure. Okay. Oh, I guess we go out. Third floor. Where should we go? Suspicious flower is refusing to let you enter the elevator. Alright, let's look at the stuff in here. Entirely unremarkable mushroom. This mushroom tastes of terrible tiramisu. Eating this mushroom causes one's ears to liquefy. This mushroom houses a colony of schnarbles. This mushroom would prefer to be left alone. It doesn't like people. A cluster of conspiratorial mushrooms. So what are these little things? Nothing? This mushroom is asleep. This mushroom is purring. A rather bad portrait of Vanessa, mysterious druid who famously invented the exploding garden hose. Portrait of the lovely Mora, mysterious druid. Portrait of Bedelia, mysterious druid. Mushroom of the species Amanita squeakina. Bob the spider once built a galleon under this mushroom. This mushroom is tending its spores. Two married mushrooms. Oh, there's a bat here. Alright, let's go out. Let's just look at this stuff first. Get this done with. Yeah, I looked at those. Ceiling cabbage. Looks like a mushroom, but it isn't one. A bit of ceiling cabbage. Alright. Refusing to let me enter the elevator. Let's talk to Suspicious Flower first. The smell of the day is paranoia. Yeah, what do you want? That's about itself. Who's asking? Paranoid? Who told you that? Elevator? I ain't letting you in there. I don't know you from Jake. I don't even know who Jake is, and I sure as hell ain't gonna take your word on the matter. My scroll's been updated. Ask thee about the suspicious flower not letting you into the elevator, okay? Right, let's talk to this bat. Patricia Quinn. Hello, Yawn. Smell the day's magenta. So about herself? I'm quite fine, thank you. A little tired as all. I'm a creature of the night, you know. What about Transylvania? Yes, that's where I'm from. Transylvania. The planet, that is, not the region. Why does everyone get that mixed up? Can you tell me? What about the foreclosure? It's ridiculous. Since when can someone own a cave? We live here, they don't. So why not leave us alone? What about the Isle of the Moon? I've only seen the forests, really. They're quite beautiful. Though once I accidentally flew into this one forest that was all petrified. That was scary. What about humidity? Is it just me, or does the humidity keep changing? And it's much too high. I think there's something wrong. So I bumped the mic there. Okay, fix Underhome's humidity settings. So we're getting a bit of quests here, and I guess when it goes past here, we can scroll? Possibly. So let's go back here. Ask him about the suspicious flower. Oh, for the love of... Please tell that paranoid plant that if he keeps this up, I'll take away his fedora. I know where he's hidden it. Maybe I shouldn't get so angry. He means well. Not that he can really stop anyone, except by staring them to death. Oops, I put that by mistake. Let's go back out. Before I go into the other floor, though, let's just check the right. Oh my god, a room of boxes. Let's not start rummaging through these boxes unless you have to. At some point I'm gonna have to, aren't I? Let's go left. Library. Alright. Feel free to skip the rest of this video, guys. I'm just gonna look at all these titles. And if I find anything interesting, I'll recap in the next video. Let's see what we got here. On the Science of Napping by Mick Rogataki. Cellular Degeneration in the Brain of the Objectivist by Dr. Crustaceous McShellfish. Character from the Book of Living Magic. Hear the Words of the Ancient Grouse by Bolonius Snickerton. Hellboy, Complete Edition by Mike Mignola. Excellent. Onoropolis University Guide to Viscous Soups by Department of Abominable Substances. Don't Call Me a Monkey by Uckbert Appledorn. Condor Man by Woodrow Wilkins. On the Manifold Applications of Bananas by Uckbert Appledorn. Rise of the Video Game Sinisters by Anna Anthropy. Fishy Fishy in the Sea by Georgina Cumberbottom. Pleasure Thresholds by Patricia Tallman. That, I just saw that book in The Fabulous Screech. It is a Babylon 5 reference. And that's all I'll say about that. Lagonia, Life and Death of a City by Ravenlock Smith. Main character of the Book of Living Magic. When Mitosa Smells by Mr. Nose. I Am a Horse by Mara Stumblebrain. The End of History and Other Myths by Denmas Clenace. Fashionable Nonsense, Postmodern Intellectuals Abuse of Science by Alan Sokal and Jean Brickmont. Excuse me. The Safety Electron by Joel the Hatless. The Great Green Book of Mold by Aspergillus. Aspergillus. Jaron Duga's Incomplete Guide to Non-Fictional Disease Prevention, Abridged. Tigana by Guy Gabriel Kay. Onoropolis University Guide to the Literature of Baslak, edited by Judah Lowe. Iron Council by China Miville. I Am the Bear Man, an Odar biography, by Sebastian Ursus Prisser. Attempts on Our Lives by Martin Shrimp. Onoropolis University Dictionary of Non-Existent Terms, first edition. Encyclopedia Trifusica, Trifusus. The Material Causes on the Third War of Magic by Ravenlock Smith. Cthulhu is Nice Once You Get to Know Him, an autobiography by Antonius Quinn. Cult D Relative in Fact was a Spurchen Zind by Frederick William von Jurist. Rebuilding the Colossus by Chairs of Lindos. Das Kapital, Volume 4 by Karl Marx. The Great Encyclopedia of Pseudoscience, Mimetics to Milkology. I stepped on the Frankfurt School and it made a squishy sound. By Gigantus Bean Trinket. It's a mushroom. A highly literate mushroom. Excuse me, guys. A staff from the Kingdom of the Enigmatic Snakes belonged to Alexander, Mysterious Druid. A walking wand made of wonton. A very powerful magical umbrella. Could do almost anything, except keep the rain away. Why would it do that? A magic stick that harnesses the power of germs. In other words, it does nothing. Let's look at this side of books. Oh, the cool little curtains. A polythronic armchair from Billion Toad City. Alright. The Mystery of Princess Talara by Mira Licketh. That is a book from Skyrim. Oh, another Elder Scrolls games. Sorry. Mordavia, A Personal View by Boris Stovich. The Book of Jakar by Jakar, another Babylon 5 reference. I'm probably getting about 10% of the references here, guys, so fill in the blanks. Your own experience. The Voyage of the Darwin by Peter S. Beagle. Star Maker by Olaf Stapledon. New Age of the Fist, A Guide to Opposing Postmodernism by Alastair Hewlett. The Complete Dark Tower by Stephen King. I've read the first one. New Poems from Onoropolis by Allen Ginsberg. My Bondage and My Freedom by Frederick Douglass. Antecedents of Dwemer Law, author unknown. It's another book from the Elder Scrolls series. Onoropolis University Guide to Nexus City, edited by Horace Johnson. Let Us Now Praise Famous Death Dwarves, extended edition by Lester Bangs. Those Damn Baboons, a children's novel by Lucinda Strongoforth. I'm Going to Kill Those Baboons, a children's novel by Lucinda Strongoforth. Someone Stop Those Baboons, etc. Death by Baboons It Shall Be. Protocols on the Elders of Baboonia. Same author and everything. Final Solution to the Baboon Problem. The Sad Decline of Lucinda Strongoforth. Collected Essays by Papio Hamadryas. The Prophetic Properties of Chocolate by Siocled Nam. The Shivering Bestiary by Namler Esprink. The Importance of Puns in the Release of Magical Energies by Master Erasmus of Zauberberg. Book of Opinions on the People of the Ideal City by Al-Farabi. Capybara, Capybara, etc. by Teddy Capybara. Terry, sorry. The Onoropolis Compendium, Book 4 by Jonas and Verena Kyratzes. Greetings from the Culture by Ian M. Banks. The Chronicles of Amber by Roger Zelazny, annotated by the Mutant Priests of Gloop. The Writings of Vivek, A Critical Examination by Vandam Bars. Vivek is a character from the Elder Scrolls series. One Country by Ali Abunama. Incredible Adventures of the Fabulous Screech by the Fabulous Screech. I highly recommend that game, guys. It took me a half hour to play, and that was like reading almost everything. Freedom and Death by Nikos Kazantzakis. Delphic Utterus by Angelus Stikelianos. Alright, let's look at these miscellaneous things and then read these books and we'll be done. It would appear to be an enormous tooth. A biogenic photo of a desert landscape on the Isle of the Stars. You find a bottle of Bolsha whiskey. The screen measures the inventory's gravimetric pulse patterns. The inventory's auxiliary spatial discriminators are fully functional. On this screen, you can observe the alternating states of the inventory's temporal data bank. Am I in my inventory? Not even the knows what the screen is about. A chameleon mushroom disguised as a bit of interface. This dial monitors the inventory's built-in thermal pilar dimensional singularity. Nothing happens. The button this button may still be growing. This button plays an annoying squeaking sound. I don't find it that annoying. You set the item pickup sound to standard sound. Not standard sound. Okay. This is what the object you pick up would look like in a black and white photo. It's not a button. How do I change it back to color? Alright. Is it my Ulster whiskey? Okay. It's a strong red whiskey. In Trotsky's. It smells of historical materialism. As tempting as it might be to drink, you need to use this as an alchemical ingredient. The mouse says it's too proletarian for this solution, for this potion. Okay, so we picked that up. It's a diamond. The color indicates it's probably a communist. You find the decipher restart desk. Oh, so I pick it up? Okay, let's go back to standard sound then. A disc for restarting a device called the decipherer. Just find the decipher and stick this into the appropriate slot. It smells of wood. Eating wood may be fun, but you need this. You might need this. The mouse is bored by this thing. Alright. The Poverty of Philosophy by Karl Marx. The Worm Ouroboros by E.R. Edison. Paperweight by Stephen Fry. Nothing else in there. Oh, I got these books. Getting late, isn't it? Alright. Let's go to a new Let's Play, and I will finish reading these books. Well, reading the titles of the books. What is this thing? Triangle. Smell the day. Mathematics. I can talk to this thing. The answer is no. Okay. That's it. Several logs of photonic quantum wood. Alright. Well, thanks for watching, guys. I know, not much accomplished. But hey, that's why I'm reading everything. Because I'm reading everything. Thanks again, and hope to see you next time. And this is Nordpudding.